The Scheme Villains Self-Saving System, Chapter 73 Extra. Airplanes Fortuitous Encounter, Audio Source, WhooshaWorldAudiobook.com. Note that this extra is Chapter 73 in the Roars. The next chapter will continue the story. For now, enjoy this extra. Comma. Chapter 73 Extra, Airplanes Fortuitous Encounter. Airplane Shooting Towards the Sky was a stallion novel writer. A relatively reputable stallion novel writer. A stallion novel writer who, even on the Jungdian novel site with writing deities running all over the place unless a writer sprouting up like grass on prime soil, was spoken of by others with some frequency. That perseverance in cramming 3 years' worth of work into one, releasing 10,000 words a day with expert speed and willpower, those periodic 8-chapter burst releases, that daring energy engulfing the whole country. To those writers who had followed the same path up from openly prostrating themselves on the streets, it was a legend only to be glimpsed but not attained, a myth that would take audiences but not demands. Those harem episodes which had their integrity eaten by dogs, as well as those storylines which had their IQ eaten by dogs, merely signified the depth and characteristics of his style enthusiastically discussed by his millions of readers. Regarding his works, the most common assessment was a mindless book. One, of course, it's a mindless book. But what a satisfying read. That's right, Airplane Flying Towards the Sky's newest masterpiece, Proud Immortal Demon Way, was that typical kind of novel with many haters but even more fans. This sort of plaything was collectively known to everyone as a red book with no reputation. The people who liked it loved it, and the people who hated it could stomp it into the shit and spit on it several times without satisfying their hatred. This type of controversial work would always be a prime breeding ground for people picking fights. For example, right now, while Airplane Shooting Towards the Sky was mindlessly hammering out today's new content, he opened up a certain well-known novel forum, ready to spout nonsense to freeload points. Hurriedly sweeping his eyes over the page, the first glance made him shudder, having landed on a trending post with an aggressive title bearing his pen name and the title of his book fiercely bobbing up and down on the homepage. This was not the first time he had been on the scene while people were fighting over his works. As always, Airplane Shooting Toward the Sky didn't hesitate to join in on the excitement, gleefully clicking on the link. Sure enough, it was a familiar recipe, familiar taste. Number 1, 10 years of reading sharpens one's sword up. After reading web novels for close to 10 years, I've never seen a cultivation novel as rotten as Proud Immortal Demon Way. Oh wait, spending day and night eating, sleeping, and collecting sisters, and you fucking tell me this is a cultivation novel? The logic can go die, the writing style can go die, and the author can bleep with it. Last year I bought a pack. Rage, rage, rage. People who like this book come here and tell me, what part of it do you even like? What sort of mindset do you have to be in? How much do you have to hate everyone else to recommend this book? I really can't bear it, I'm done. Number 2, your infatuated pupil. I've wanted to roast for a long time, sweating. Is there even any meaning to the ranking system? There's no difference between the golden core in the nascent soul stage and in normal people. Every time I see more writing about eating food and sleeping, I can't bear to continue, it's really just bare decoration. And face slapping once or twice is all right, but if you face slap 1,000 times in the same way, it's really just boring. In short, it's simply not as cool as they say, there's a bit of an Amway scam feeling to the whole thing. Anyways, this book's fans are very swift and fierce, I'd estimate they're going to gang up on you soon. Best of luck, op, I'll send you a pot lid, I'm out. Number 3, Swordsman Must Say. The writing is shit. All the readers are idiots. Number 4. You, this sin cannot be forgiven. Who are you calling an idiot up there? What a low character. Number 5. Taking red for green, one after another. Before I jabbed open this post, I knew it would be going in this sort of direction. Every time people start chatting about this book, they start arguing. I've never seen a single exception. Pull up a chair and watch the fun. Number 6. You, this sin cannot be forgiven. I'm bored to death of you guys arguing every time. What's there to argue about? Just because you don't like it doesn't mean other people won't like it. It's really simple logic. If you like it, then read it. If not, then get lost. Write your own story. You can you up, you understand? 3. Op started spewing BS before they even finished. What's the point of spewing BS just for the sake of spewing? Number 7. 10 years of reading sharpens one sword. Watch and see, kiddos. We've even got an AU can up. This is really just rubbing the dog's head. 4. Kid, read novels for a few more years. Is it really good for you to waste your time on the forums before break? If you can't finish your homework, watch out, or your teacher's going to tell your parents. Just because you like it doesn't mean other people will like it. I'm quoting your own words back to you. Also, I don't need to finish eating a ball of shit before I realize it's a ball of shit, okay? Number 8. Sha Huling's little bell. Heart, drooling, drooling. I don't think it's as rotten as Op says. I like reading this book. I like Sister Sha. Hue, hue, hue. Number 9. Peerless Cumber Expert. I understand what Op is thinking. Lately, I've been reading this book straight through. It's so damn long, long and pumped full of filler. I've never seen villains with a lower IQ than the ones in this book. The average cannon fodder has an IQ of 40 and the protagonists have an IQ of 60. It's like the author went on a 24-hour face-slapping craze without losing steam. Most of the female protagonists are stupid flower vases, and you don't even push down Lu Mingyan, the only righteous one. You don't push down the righteous empress, are you fucking kidding me? Airplane, hand over the girlfriends, I'll eat this book raw. All my fellow readers have already roasted it for 300,000 words, so I'll stop talking. In fact, the most interesting thing are the monsters of the demon realm. It'd be best if those were written about more. The rest is just throwing 50 sisters into the family. Each one doesn't even have a distinguishable personality. The writing style is so weird. Each time a woman appears, it's her soft chest trembled. You could at least try a different phrase for shivering mud. A different word would be finer. Seriously, what substitute teacher taught airplane literature in elementary school? At least the portrayal of the male lead was all right. The transformation from innocent and upstanding to hateful and sinister was detailed and natural. Debts of kindness and grudges were paid off. Those who should have been killed were mercilessly killed. Seeing that sort of lovey-dovey male lead just makes me want to steal his girl. Bing Ji deserves that. Gee, he's cool enough and blackened enough. I like it, ha. Shen Qingchu, this cheap person doesn't bear explain. Number 10. Kang Keong, Mountain Stair Cleaning Manager. Does anyone here like Yue Zhangmen? I like the warm oil attack the most, whispering, silently passing by. Number 11. Warrior's Hammer. Boring. It's not written as well as Immortal XX Battle. The difference is huge. This is what's called a real cultivation novel. Number 12. You, this sin cannot be forgiven. Teacher, trampling on praise feels good, doesn't it? Ha. Number 13. Refusing to be a potholer. The ninth floor's Cumber Bro wrote that many words just to hate on it. It must be true love. Number 14. 10 years of reading sharpens one sword. To answer floor 12, he I don't dare accept, I'll return the original to you. Are there not that many proud immortal fans who leap up to trample other books? Do you want me to flip through my records for some screenshots to fling in your face? Number 15, Kangkiong Mountain Gate Guard Platoon. To answer floor 10, does anyone here like Yue Zhangmen? Whispering, silently passing by. Grab the sister on floor 10. You're a sister, right? I also like Zhangmen Shisheng. I like him a lot. Is there anything more mo than pampering and indulging something with no bottom line? WuxiaWorldAudio.com. Comma question mark. Back quote. It's a pity the partner was this disastrous a shidi. The bad ending was so complete I couldn't read any comfort out of it. Number 16. Dear Brother Chinga, 6. Don't resolve that bitch Shen Qing Chu plus 10086. My god, floor 15 can even mo over this type of scum. I always felt it was a pity Bizarre Peak's peak lord died that early. Airplane Ju just refused to write to him, or else there would be more CPs to contend with. Number 17. Occasionally filling holes. There's so much info in those last few levels. Did this forum get invaded by weirdos? Number 18. Peerless Cumber Expert. Upstairs, calm down. This form has a lot of green ding ding net sisters, sunglasses. Number 19. A stately waiter. It really is true love for Cumber Bro. It's just the stuff he spews here isn't as vicious as what he puts in the reviews. Not malicious enough, poor evaluation. Number 20. Hoeing wheat is my noontime occupation. The proud immortal fans are here to stir up trouble again. I see this book everywhere. It makes me want to puke. This book's quality isn't worth this much passion. If you say Airplane didn't invite the Navy, I wouldn't believe it. Sit and wait for the next time the Skill Emperor opens an invitation. Look and you'll know if he got a ticket or not. Number 21. Hoeing wheat is my noontime occupation. To answer floor 4, who are you calling an idiot up there? What a low character. You're joking. The school kids who like to read rotten books like Proud Immortal have the nerve to talk about character. No one has as low a character as you. Number 22. Dear Brother Chinga. Because those one or two people firing area cannons are all drunk. Seeing floor 20 stir up the discussion, isn't this trumpeting for landlord? Not to speak of anything else, just look at Airplane's update rate. 10k every day and 25k on the weekends, how many people can do it? And first put the question of quality to the side. Number 23. Looking for hungry friends at the North Pole every day. This fan wrote some Bing GEX scum Shen slash Z don't know if anyone wants to see. 7. It's so painful, mo over a cold CP is like going to the North Pole. I'm also just courting death looking for CP in a Jungdian novel. Number 24. Kang Kiong Mountain Stair Cleaning Manager. The slash writing sister, don't go. Is it with the 8th letter Lord? Please woo. Number 25. Occasionally filling holes. Airplane really doesn't know how to write romance plot lines, best if he just doesn't. I feel like Luo Binger doesn't have feelings for any of his wives, he just wants to use them. And I can't see any of those women with real moving emotion for him. Number 26. Warrior's Hammer. As long as he collects all the sisters it's fine, it's whatever if there's emotion or not. Number 26. Peerless Cumber Expert 8. Filling holes bro on floor 25, you're joking, do you want Airplane not to write the harem? Two-thirds of the book would be gone. Number 27. Taking red for green, one after another. But I feel like I can see which peak lord has real moving emotion for which peak lord. Hoping for the skies. Seriously speaking. The scenes he wrote with emotional interactions between brothers were all much more exquisite and natural than Bing Ji's scenes with his wives. They practically contain deep love visible to the bare eyes. Airplane really is a natural expert food anchi. P.S. The sister on floor 24, beggars can't be choosers. Number 28. Hoeing wheat is my noontime occupation. This level was blocked due to personal attack, currently waiting for writer to edit. Airplane shooting towards the skydew, while stirring his instant noodles with one leg propped, nonchalantly rolled the scroll wheel on his mouse, skimming over the forum posts. His eyes automatically highlighted every message from that familiar IDP Alice Cumber. Black sniping like a running stream, a Cumber made of iron. Even though this famous Lord Cumber would constantly spew criticism without end in his review sections, his subscriptions and urges for updates never slowed a bit. Because of this, he always suspected this person was a masochist. "Very good, you have successfully attracted my attention." Like some sort of tyrant chairman, Airplane Jew began to nonchalantly observe Cumber Bros bluster in the review sections. In the end, he concluded, "It's just like if a woman was married to a disappointing husband, itching to ride on his back, grab him by the neck, and shake, kissing and spitting on him with mixed love and hate." Peerless Cumber was locked in precisely this kind of inextricable chase while giving a loathing, "Why can't I control this damn author of the novel I chose to read?" an upright body with a mouthful of resentment. Airplane Jew lay down his final conclusion and smacked his computer table, howling with laughter. This one smack was disastrous. The instant noodles toppled over, splashing all over his hard-working and meritorious beloved keyboard, spicy broth flowing 1,000 miles. Airplane turned pale with fright, quickly jumping up to rescue it. But he jumped too high and his foot caught on the power strip. With a crackle, his laptop screen went dark. After this chain reaction of extreme joy turning to sorrow, Airplane's face was deathly white. WTFF. He was just scrolling forums while downloading movies and padding his word count. His file was still open. Fuck, he couldn't have lost today's update just like this. He'd gotten to 8,000 a. He subconsciously threw himself down next to the power strip, picking up the wire to shove it back in the socket. And experienced firsthand what could be called electricity running through the whole body, godly thunder from the ninth heaven, end chapter.